Hi everyone, my name is Rama Diosofi. Today I'm going to review one of the children literature that I've read. Actually, I'm planning to review The Gingerbread Man, but since I don't clearly remember the stories or the main point in it, so I changed to the other story that I still remember, titled Goldilocks and the Three Bears. There are a lot of versions of the story, but the one that I will talk about now is the Robert Southey's one. This story tells about a girl named Goldilocks that goes to the forest and finds a house inside. She tries to check if somebody home, but she gets no answer. Yet, she still insists to get inside the house and eat all the foods, sits in the chairs, and try all the beds and sleep on one of it. Later, the family bears come, who turns out to be the owner of the house. They just back from the trip. They enter the house and surprised to see what the Goldilocks has done. Their food has been eaten, their chairs are broken, and the bed messed up. The bears then find Goldilocks sleeping on the bed, stare at her, that she suddenly wakes up and sees the bears. She gets frightened and tries to run away as fast as she can before the bears chase her. And never come back to the forest or the house again. In the story, the readers can learn about other properties and how bad trespassing is. Whenever you want to use things that not belongs to you, it's a must for you to ask for the owner permission. It's just as the same as stealing if you use someone's stuff without their permission. Then the readers can also find out it's bad for being selfish. It can hurt other people or give them disadvantage. And don't forget, curiosity can lead to trouble, just like Goldilocks that curious about the house and still enter the house even she didn't find the owners inside. Yes, it's good to be curious about things, but you need to know the boundaries of what we can or cannot do, which one is safe or dangerous, no matter how curious we are. And personal, I like these stories and it's quite simple and enjoyable. I recommend this story to be taught to children since it has good messages, kind of simple and straightforward by showing Goldilocks' bad behaviors and how it affects the three bears. If you want to try another version of Goldilocks and the three bears, I suggest you to check the story or which version is before giving it to children since some versions are kind of dark. Like giving tales about Goldilocks that get eaten by the three bears in the end of the story that might scare the children or give them traumas. So that's all I can tell you. I'm sorry if I made mistakes since humor is not perfect. You can give your critics or suggestions in comment sections. I'm open with it as long as it can improve my skills. And thanks for watching. See you next time.